So I'll show you how fairly quickly you can test the wastegate operation on your turbo. So if you really have overboost or underboost in your turbo in 1.6 HDI engines, stay tuned. So really have bought the cheapest turbo possible on eBay just to do some tests on it, so it's much easier to show outside of the car, and then I'll show you how it's inside. So this is really a fairly cheap, very cheap turbo. It's I'll give the numbers specifications of this turbo, so it looks like that. So this is really the wastegate actuator arm. So what it really does, there is a spring inside and a rubber membrane. So when basically is to relieve pressure inside the turbo. I'll show the operation. So basically there is a rod that moves. Let me show it. So there is a rod that moves. So first of all, you really have to make sure that this rod is not seized. It's not stuck. So you can push it or hold it, and it has to really go back the spring. The spring works. The really simple test is basically what you can test if the diaphragm can hold vacuum, and this is the vacuum from the vacuum pump or the turbo vacuum solenoid. So basically, you push the rod to as far as it can go, plug this hole, and then release. This shouldn't go back, and then when you release, you can see how it holds vacuum. So it really holds vacuum and doesn't release. So this is really a simple test to show that the wastegate, well, basically on the engine is like that. So you can push that rod, plug this hole, and then release, and then you know that this holds vacuum and it works. So what does the wastegate do? So this is really the turbine part, the turbo oil. If I rotate it from the compressor side, this really rotates there as well. So the gases really go through here, and then turn the turbine so it compresses air. So this is really the wastegate. Let me hold it. This is really the wastegate. There you can see how it's closing. When you push that rod, it closes. There we go. So when it's open, it really relieves the pressure. So two things really. That I check if that has not seized, and if really if the diaphragm holds vacuum. So I'll now show you how you can do it actually on the car. That's the same turbo as the other one. Here is the vacuum hose that goes to the vacuum solenoid, and this is the wastegate actuator down here. So first of all, you really need to remove the hose here, and it's not too easy. So basically, you can push it slightly, and then kind of undo it. I move the camera a bit, so push it. It's better be done on a warm engine, but everything's really warm. So basically, you pull the vacuum hose there. So this is the same actuator plug. This is the same thing inside the car. It's just the shield is here, so I cannot really quite easily push this rod. So I have a metal thing just to leverage on the shield, and just to see if this really operates, if this pushes, it's not seized. So you can see it's actually moving down there. So next thing is really to push that rod, poke the hole at the bottom, and then release. This should stay, so it holds vacuum, and then when release it, this will really move here, down here. See how it moves? So really know that this holds vacuum. And it works. If you really have underboost, so for example, this has seized, the rod has seized, and it doesn't move at all. So it really, the wastegate is always open, and you don't get any boost. Or if it's seized in a closed position, you get overboost or underboost, of course, if that doesn't hold vacuum and the diaphragm is somewhat broken. Or if, well, the other thing is if the diaphragm is working and you get underboost, it might not have vacuum. The solenoid might be wrong, but this is how an easy way to really test the wastegate in 1.6 HDI engines. In addition to all of this, when you start the car, the vacuum pump should create enough vacuum through the solenoid. The turbo boost solenoid should really create vacuum and pull the wastegate and pull these rods. So when you start the car, really should see this rod straight away pulled to the closed position, so the wastegate gets closed. So this is an addition, so if you have a camera or somebody else can look into when you start the engine from cold, whether this rod gets pulled. Thank you very much indeed for watching. Hope that was really useful to someone. Subscribe, let me know for any comments in the comment sections. Thank you.